This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. So there are many ways to insert data into the Django database. We could use the Django admin site, we could open up a terminal and just insert manually, or else we could utilize tools such as Factory Boy and Faker, which is going to provide us tools to automatically generate data and for us to be able to specify how much data we want to insert into our database. Right, so let's take a look. So I'm going to Control C to close this server. The first thing we're going to need to do is actually install the tools for this. So Factory Boy and Faker. Now, if you install Factory Boy, it does come, I believe, with Faker, so you don't have to install that separately. So let's take a look. I'm just going to open up a browser here, type in PyPI, the Python package index. So that's where I'm going to find all the packages. I'm going to type in Factory Boy and give that a go. So here we are. Top option here. So we have Factory Boy 3.2.1 released. It's always good to check and make sure you've got the latest version, of course. So we are in actual fact going to install Factory Boy 3.2.1. So you can see pip install Factory Boy. So I'm just going to press this, copy that, go back in here, paste that in, and install Factory Boy. So like I said, by installing Factory Boy, you can see the different packages that have been installed. And you can see one of them is in actual fact Faker here. So it's installing Faker for us, so we don't necessarily need to install that separately. Now, because we have made changes to the dependencies for this project, we are going to now update the requirements. So this is the current requirement. So let's just do a pip freeze and then just change these requirements. And you can now see by doing that, it's now included Faker, Factory Boy, and some other dependencies. Okay, so with that in place, I think we're ready to go ahead and create a new factory. So within the SQL query app here, let's create a new file. So I'm going to call this factory, factory.py. So here, essentially, what I'm specifying here is an approach which Factory Boy, or that we can use in order to insert data into the database. What do we need to know? If we wanted to insert data into our database, we would need to know the names of the fields and the table that we want to insert data into. So that's essentially what we're doing here. We're building a platform. We're building a factory so that we can tell our factory, oh, I want to order 100 rows of data. Then our factory can then produce those 100 rows of data. So let's import factory. Okay. And then from Django, we don't need that. So import factory, let me just think, from factory dot Faker. Yep, let's import Faker as well. We're going to need that. Trying to think about what we're going to need. Well, we're going to need some models. So from dot model, so dot referring to this folder where we are in. Now remember, the models are inside the same folder, so just dot models referencing this module here, modules. And then let's import our model, which is product. And then we just need to set up Faker. So fake equals Faker dot Faker, and that will allow us to use Faker within our project. I'll just drop this down. Right, zoom out a little bit. Okay, so with that in place, let's now build our product factory. So I'm going to call this product factory. Seems like a good name. And I'm just going to bring in the tools that I need to actually build our factory. So Factory Boy does provide specific tools for Django. So I can use my models as factories. So class meta. So we're first of all just going to define which model we want to use. Okay, so now we know what model we're using. So now we need to define the fields. So we've got a few fields. You remember we have a name field, so that now needs to be populated. So we're going to populate that with some data. We're going to use Faker for that. So what we can do here with Faker, we can specify what type of data we want to actually insert. So I'm going to add a sentence here. Remember, this is the name. So I'm going to use the tools from Faker. That's going to be sentence. And then I can specify how many words, for example. So these are all tools that are provided by Faker. So if you want to learn a little bit more, then you would need to check out the documentation. But this just gives you a sense and an idea of how this is done. So here, Faker is going to automatically generate some data. I've told it to create a sentence, and that sentence should have 12 words. Now, you don't necessarily need a sentence for a name, but it just gives you an idea. Now, Faker comes with loads of different predefined types of data for your particular needs, or you can generate your own. Okay, so slug, we need some sort of slug. The factory boy or factory Faker provides that, Faker, and then we're going to need a slug. Okay, so I'm just specifying that I want to create some slugs. And okay, so I think that's pretty much all we need, apart from is digital. Digital, yeah. So that was the other field that we had. And by default, that is set to false, I think. If you're not too sure, let's go to our models. Yeah, so by default, it is false. So we don't necessarily need to specify that. But there we go. So we now have a factory, a way of specifying how to create data and where to create it. So we can now tell our factory to create 100 or 1,000 or 10,000 products in our product table. So let's give it a go. Right, so I'll just open up my terminal, or open up the terminal. Remember, you can do that using the shortcut keys, drag from the bottom, or go to view and terminal. Right, so terminal. Inside of here, I'm just going to clear that. Right, so first of all, let's get into the Django terminal. So manage.py and then shell, so the shell. Okay, so this is a typical normal shell, but we are using the shell through Django. So it adds like a layer or a wrapper around the shell so we can interact with our Django project. Right, so from here, so let's bring in some resources. Now, SQL query. Right, so let's go ahead now and from SQL query, that's the name of our app. I wish I didn't call it that now, but SQL query. Inside of there, we have a module called factory. So from this module here, let's import our product factory. So let's give that a go. Okay, so we've imported that in. So behind the scenes, that's now available for us to use. So now we can go ahead and create some products. So let's say X equals product factory. So we're going to grab our product factory. We're going to ask it to create some products. Now we're going to create quite a few. So we're going to use the function create batch. Again, this is all in the factory boy documentation. And we're going to create 100. There we go. So we've now created 100 new entries into our table. If you have any problems at this stage, you just need to go through the code again and just take a double look. So now what I can do is, actually, I haven't imported the product table yet. So from SQL query, let's go ahead and import dot models. Let's go ahead and import the product factory so we can access the table. What have I done wrong there? SQL query dot models. What have I done there? SQL. So cannot import name product factory from models. Oh, okay. That's what I've done wrong. Okay, so I'm importing product factory. Apologies. So I just want to import the product. So I import the product. Okay, I'm just going to clear this. So I've imported the product. Remember, that's behind the scenes now. So what I can now do is inspect that product table. So let's do X equals product.objects.all. So I'm going to run a query here and grab all the data from the product table. I'm then going to print it out. And you can see this is all the data that was printed. So this is all the data that's been added into my table. You can see it's been truncated. So it's only going to show a certain amount of data. So what I can do here, in actual fact, if I command K that, Remember, X is still live, still holding that information. So what I can do now is X, and then maybe run a dot count on it. And there we go. So in actual fact, we're returning 100 rows from the database, and that's what we're expecting because we've created 100 new rows or objects in the database. Now we can inspect that further, remember. Right-click on our database, and remember you're going to need the SQLite extension installed, like I showed earlier. Go into your database here, look for your table, right-click, show the table, and now what we have is, well, we have 100 new rows. So you can see this is all the data that's been generated by Faker. You can move across. If you go to the bottom here, you can have a look across. So those are the slugs that have been created and is digital. So notice it's zero rather than false, because false is represented as zero. True would be represented as one. So now that we have some data, we can now go ahead and inspect that from our resource that we created here in the view. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to clear the terminal, going to run the server again, manage.py. Okay, that's one thing. We need to exit this. So if you see the triple right chevrons, that means you're still in the shell. So we're just going to exit that, and there are different ways of exiting. So just type in exit and then the parentheses, that's just one way. So now we can go ahead and access manage.py and then run server. So we can then start the server. So remember, our view should run the query of grabbing all the data from the product table, and it should return it to us because we've serialized that data and prepared it in a way so that we can receive that response. So let's go back to that page, 127.0.0.1:8000. And there we go. I'm just going to zoom out. So that's all the data that's been returned from the database. Now, remember, if you're struggling to remember the URL address for it, it's just down here in the terminal, 127.0.0.1:8000. The significance of this number, if you didn't know, is a loopback address. So an IP address that's been assigned to your computer. So you're essentially just sending a message to your own computer. Your computer is obviously hosting Django. When you start the Django server, it's looking out for any requests on this port on this IP address, which is obviously your local IP address, your computer IP address. So when you send, when you open up the browser, type it in, you're sending a request to your own computer, which will then be picked up by your Django server, which is running on your own computer, thus being able to then serve this web page back to your browser.